Moving on to Chapter 2, we'll now explore working with plant 3D files. To begin, let's open our project by navigating through Project Manager. We'll open the files from the desktop, specifically the exercise files for Chapter 2. Next, we'll select the project XML file. Since plant 3D models contain both graphical data and information, it's important that you always create new models within Project Manager. These models should be created under the Plant 3D Drawings section of the Project Manager's directory. For this exercise, let's expand the Plant 3D node in the directory tree to view the files and subfolders. We'll start by creating a new drawing under the piping folder. Keep in mind that the folder you have selected is where the new drawing will be created, so if you want to continue working in the piping folder, select it and right-click to create a new drawing. We'll name the drawing 02_01_piping. Notice that the folder path can't be changed, as it's predetermined by the project setup. You'll need to accept this location and click OK. Once created, the drawing will become the active file, and you'll see it displayed on the tab. The new drawing, 02_01_piping, will now appear in the directory tree. By creating the drawing this way, you ensure that it is properly registered into the project. Now, to demonstrate the difference between creating drawings in Project Manager, I'll create a drawing within the P&ID section, which uses a separate 2D database. Right-click on the P&ID drawing section, create a new drawing, and name it P&ID. You'll notice that the drawing looks slightly different, as it uses a P&ID title block, but we're still within the 3D workspace. If I attempt to route piping here, an error message will appear, indicating that the command is not compatible with the current drawing. It will ask if you'd like to switch workspaces. This safeguard ensures that you don't accidentally create a 3D model in the P&ID area or vice versa. By doing this, Plant 3D prevents you from accessing the wrong tool palettes and creating files in incorrect locations.